Here the worshipers! Where's all of my praises? I want everybody around the world to put your hands together because all the praise belongs to God. Here we go.
My name is Trisha Hamilton, and this is the good news announcements for the month of July. Welcome to St. John's United Methodist Church, the church in the heart of Watts with Watts at Heart, where we are celebrating 100 years of ministry. Happy birthday to all those born in the month of July. We wish you an amazing and blessed year. Please enjoy a safe and fun 4th of July with family and friends. Well, it's summer. You know what that means. Summer brings about some amazing events that you need to know about. We're going to have a good old-fashioned picnic with food, games, prizes, and a baking contest. Bake or fix your best and your favorite desserts that you would like to share. And all of the participants will get to taste and vote on their most favorite dessert. So, wear your church t-shirt if you have one, and bring your chairs, your blankets, and other food that you wish to bring, and come and have fun in the park. We will begin with worship at 10 a.m. and have activities the rest of the day. Join us at El Dorado Park on Sunday, July 12th. See the flyers for more details. You know what else is coming this summer? Is the Back to School Backpack Giveaway. It will be Saturday, August 12th from 9 to 12 p.m. This year, Metro Kids is back by special demand and will provide the Bible fun and activities. There will be a food truck providing free meals and a game truck for all those video gamers out there, and free haircuts will be available. All activities will be on the church parking lot. Please share this info with your family and friends with kids. See the flyer that was sent out for more details. See you there. Did you know that every 4 years, our youth participate in one of the largest youth events that our church has to offer? Our youth will be leaving for Youth 2023 at the end of July, where they will participate in worship, workshops, and service projects. Please keep the youth leaders and youth in prayer as they travel to Daytona Beach, Florida.
Call to worship. Welcome. This is a time to celebrate and worship God who loves us. We are grateful and thankful for all God's blessing in our lives. We gather to remember that Christ gave his life for us. We humbly praise God for such a gift. Come, friends, come and worship the God of love and hope. Praise be to God at all times and in all places. Amen.
I will bless the Lord at all times. I will bless the Lord at all times. I will bless the Lord at all times.
Today's scripture reading comes from Psalms 86, verses 1 through 10 and 16 and 17. And it reads, verse 1, "Incline your ear, O Lord, and answer me, for I am poor and needy. Preserve my life, for I am devoted to you. Save your servant who trusts in you. You are my God. Be gracious to me, O Lord, for to you I do cry all day long. Gladden the soul of your servant. For you, O Lord, I lift up my soul. For you, O Lord, are good and forgiving, abounding in steadfast love to all who call on you." Verse 6. "Give ear, O Lord, to my prayer. Listen to my cry of supplication. In the day of my trouble, I call on you, for you will answer me. There is none like you among the gods, O Lord, nor are there any works like yours. All the nations you have made shall come and bow down before you, O Lord, and shall glorify your name. Verse 10, for you are great and do wondrous things. You alone are God. Verse 16, turn to me and be gracious to me. Give your strength to your servant. Save the child of your serving girl. Show me a sign of your favor so that those who hate me may see it and be put to shame, because you, Lord, have helped me and comforted me. The word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God.
Bless me, God, in me. And just give me fear, here's a victory. Bless me, God, not just for me, but so everyone around me can have everything they need. Let all these folks that's in me, God, have everything they need. Bless me, God, in me. And just give me fear, here's a victory. Bless me, God, not just for me, but so everyone around me can have everything they need.
out of order today, but I just need the church to know that I love you and thank you for all the prayers that you have been giving to my family through this week. And I'll just tell you that the three songs that I can wrap this whole testimony around is, the first song you sung was, "Woke up this morning with my mind on you." I'm so glad to wake up this morning with my mind on Jesus. It's been a rough week, and it's a good thing that you can wake up and put that behind you.
Amen.
And the other prayer was, "Lord, you are good. Even in the bad times, God is good." We've gone through some bad times this week, but I know this morning, God is good. And my last song is, "How We Got Over." My soul looks back and wonder how I got over. When I think about all the struggles and the pain and the illness we have in our family right now, how we got over, we can look back and know that God is walking with us through the whole thing. I thank you for keep praying for my whole family.
Testimonies. Let's pray. God in heaven, we come before your throne of grace and mercy on this morning. God, just pausing now to give you thanks for being God and God alone. God, the word of God says that the grass will wither and the flowers will fade, but the word of God promises to last forever. God, as I stand in this moment, I ask for your Holy Spirit to give clarity of thought, articulation of speech, and movement through the word of God, so that the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in your sight, for you are our strength and redeemer. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Let the church say,
Amen.
And as has been read in your hearing from that passage of scripture, I'd just like to lift up this one verse as we hear God speak to us from this text. Genesis 19 and 17. And it reads thusly, "As soon as they had brought them out, one of them said, 'Flee for our lives. Don't look back.
All right.
And don't stop anywhere in the plain. Flee to the mountains or you will be swept away.'" This is the word of God for the people of God.
Thanks be to God.
You'll allow me just a moment to use this tag for the text that has been read in your hearing. Don't look back. Don't look back. Don't look back. Don't look back.
Y'all
gotta work
bad.
Don't look back.
Won't he do it?
There is a scene in The Color Purple where Celie is at a dinner table with her family and husband, Mr. And Mr. stands and does this exhortation in the midst of these people and say, "You is ugly. You is black. You is a woman." Celie stands and says, "But I'm here."
Amen.
So on today, through the twists and turns that life gives us, through the ups, the downs, the good and the bad, look at your neighbor on today and say to him, to them, "But I'm here."
But I'm here.
Oh, say it like you mean it on this one.
But I'm here.
As we come to the season by which transitions are very evident, when we look at weddings and we look at the end of a conference year for all of us that are at this place, when we look at graduations and other celebrations, we recognize that, as Ecclesiastes says to us, there is a season to everything under the sun. And so in this transitory season by which there are things and there are ways in which the Holy Spirit is moving us forward, I ask you on today, as the text would give us, to recognize nothing back there
is what God would have you to focus on.
All right.
Today, you are probably thinking about looking backwards.
Come on.
But in the reality, in the times in which we live, that if we were to be honest, we would say looking back would give us 20/20 vision for sure. It's much easier to look back at what we've done or where we've been, to see how or what we could have done to make a difference in our lives. But I tell you on today that the Holy Spirit is sending this word to you, St. John United Methodist Church, as you celebrate 100 years being here on this earth. Yes, the Lord gave to Lot's wife. In the midst of her quandary on what was ahead, God is giving instructions to you under the sound of my voice and those who would join on today. That the simple instructions that I would offer you on today, in the simplicity of who they are, is don't look back.
Amen.
With that in mind, let us look at the text in the context of which it is. That when we look and we see what was happening in this moment, that we can see in chapter 11 and 12, when Abram is told to leave Ur, a land God has shown him. It tells us, the Bible tells us, that Lot tagged alone. We're not told if Lot had a wife at this point, but if he did, we must assume that she too left Ur with her husband under the auspices of a promise that God had given to Abram. In chapter 13, the success of the family of Lot and Abraham causes strife among those that are in the community, that there is a split between the two brothers, and so Lot chooses, makes a choice to leave the Jordan Valley and leave Abraham in the desert of Cana. When we look around and we see the opportunities that God gives, many times you have to unhitch yourself from what others might say is your best plan of attack and listen to what God would say to you as you follow the Holy Spirit. So by chapter 17, we have seen that now Abraham has left Haran. And now we find Lot and his family in the city of Sodom. In chapter 18, we see that God has sent angels to appear to the brethren to let them know that a calamity was about to happen. The Bible tells us warning comes before destruction and a haughty spirit before a fall. So what does that mean, Pastor Adrian? That God will send a word of warning or precaution to those who know him and are listening to what God has to say.
Amen.
In this story, we see a woman who no doubt shares the same faith that those of us who have testified on today. The Bible does not give her a name, but I would offer you one today that this woman found herself being obedient first to her husband, first to her God, then to her husband, and then to her family. As has been shared with us, the first ecclesial institution that was made in Scripture is the family.
Amen.
Families are important to God, and families are important to the church. Families are important to the community. And so now, Lot's wife finds herself at a place of decision about her family and her faith. That if we were to be honest with ourselves on today, as we look at this situation, many of us have had to endure 3 years of COVID-19. We have endured 3 years of social unrest. We have endured the elevation of gun violence in the ways that have caused economic proportions for those in this world in which we live. So we are not ignorant of the fact that there are many things that are going on around us. And in the midst of all that is going around with that, that it can bring us a sense of grief and separation. Yeah. That the statistics say that this season in the world, mental health has taken epidemic numbers for those who are struggling with disappointment, for those that are suffering with loss, for those who are suffering with all kinds of maladies in this transition from now to what God has in the season that is to come. So when we look at Locke's wife, we can many times identify with being at a place by which a decision needs to be made. A decision that would either propel us forward or keep us at a place of comfort and familiarity. No doubt, as Lot's wife found herself 24 years in this location, she thought to herself, why should I leave? I know everything that is around, that this has become a place for me that I am familiar and comfortable with. But sometimes, beloved, the God that we serve will come and he will move us out of the place of the way that it has always been done. Many times, being comfortable would preclude us from putting ourselves in the place by which purpose is the providence by which God would give each and every one of us. Sometimes the solution is that you got to shake the dust off of your feet and move in the direction that the Holy Spirit gives us. Don't look back. We see the solution. We see in this moment that when we are at a place by which transition and change is ahead, when we begin to recognize that if we look back, that we will find ourselves reminiscing and remembering the story romantically, but sometimes that ain't always the truth. That if I would have looked back, I would see myself as a perfect size 10. If I would have looked back, I would find myself at a place that I have had and lived in a more comfortable lifestyle in the way that I lived. If I were to look back, I would look at relationships that I thought were in my best interest. However, looking back, romanticizes what really is the truth. The truth of the matter is this, my beloved, on today, that God is saying to you on this corner that you have been a pivotal part of this community here. That you have sown deep seeds right here on this corner and have a national footprint. But don't, beloved, rest on the loyals that you have had in the past. I came by as God's little errand girl to let you know the best is yet to come. Put your hands together and give God a praise. So sometimes as we seek the solution, as we come to recognize and don't look back, that our blessings often give birth to our burdens give birth to our blessings. Pain gives birth to our praise. Problems gives birth to our prayers. Trials give birth to our testimony. Fear gives birth to our faith. Agonies give birth to our assurance. Sorrow gives birth to our satisfaction. Weakness gives birth to our worship. Banishment gives birth to our belief. Opposition gives birth to our obedience. Criticism gives birth to our courage. Hurt gives birth to our hope. Misery gives birth to ministry. Suffering gives birth to our salvation. And so now as we come in this moment, beloved, I say to you, don't look back. Looking back would give you to be disqualified from what God has before you. That the moment you look back at the past and all that has gone wrong, you become like Lot's wife.
But I stopped by to let you know on today that you have the faith to believe that what is before you is greater than what is behind you. I say to you on today, the Bible says, press toward the mark of the high calling, which is in Christ Jesus. That is Philippians 3:16. So when we come on today with an indelible understanding that God is sovereign and he knows what is happening in our lives now and in the future, that by the grace of God, as we stand here on this corner on today, God is sending a word to encourage you that in this moment, as you have experienced unthought of two fires in the span of 2 years, that when you recognize all the ways in which the enemy would come to bring doubt and discouragement, in this moment when you are in the midst of the fire, recognize that you are not alone. Hallelujah. That God promises that he would be a very present help in the time of trouble. He promised that he would never give us more than we could bear without having an escape. He promised that he is a very present help. And so we come now to believe that as we stand in the midst of this transition, as we stand in the midst of looking to the hills from whence our help comes from, as we stand recognizing that we will without compromise or without criticism not look back, that the best is before you. Hallelujah. Put your hands together and give God a prayer. So as you recognize what the story has been told, that as we hear the story and we understand the solution is our faith, as we come now to understand that our faith gives rise as people who are kissed with the sun of dark hue, that we recognize that resilience is in our bellies. Yes. That when we look around and we see slavery, and we look around and we see Jim Crow, and we look around and we see civil rights movement, and we look around and we see Black Lives Matter, that we come to recognize that we as a people have been through many atrocities in the lives since 1619. Yes. But one thing that stands for sure is faith. Is what has propelled us. Faith has sustained us. Faith is what is in our DNA to help us to recognize that he didn't bring me this far to leave me. That faith means and reminds us that we can do all things. Do what? Do what? Do all things through Christ that gives us strength. So on today, you, beloved, individually and collectively, are God's handiwork. That God has come to send a word to you to look ahead, for the blessings of the Lord make rich and add no sorrow unto it. That when you begin to recognize that going forward, that God has great things in store for you as a congregation, individually, and as a movement in this community. Yeah. That if you were to think that the absence of the St. John United Methodist Church in the city of Watts would be a void, not just for you, but for the kingdom of God. Yeah. That your presence, your witness, your love unconditionally is needed right here on this corner. Yeah. That the next season might not look like it's always been. Amen. But what I can assure you on today is that God has great things in store for you. Yeah. Don't look back, my beloved. Allow yourselves to have the movement of the Holy Spirit, that when we look in Genesis and in the beginning, God created in the abyss of nothing, that because you have a faith to believe that what God says, his promises, you can stand on them. So in the midst of ashes, in the midst of broken windows, in the midst of declining membership, Double dog dare you on today to stand in the midst of what God will do through his word and declare it, believe it, and you will receive it. Put your hands together and give God a prayer. So as we take inventory on today, as I take my seat, that when we do our own self-inventory, we look and we see the ways in which this transition that is happening in the world on today would give us to look at things in our lives, in our communities, in our worlds much differently. So on today, as you take inventory of what is going on, that you see that when you look forward, that there are relationships, contracts, and networks. There is talent, abilities, energy, and strength. There is intellect, intuition, ideas, interest, and passion. There are resources, possessions, time, and influence. So how do you know that, Pastor Adrian? Because Ephesians 3 and 20 says, God is able to do immeasurably more than you can ask, think, or imagine, according to the power that rests in you. So how do I know that? Because the psalmist and our history would tell us this. We've come this far by faith. Leaning on the Lord. Trusting in his holy word. Why? Come on in. Come on in. He has never failed me yet. Oh. I can't turn around. Because we come this far by faith. Don't look back.
Tell one more person. Tell one more person. If you're looking for somebody, he's gone. He don't need nobody else. There's no question of your greatness, nor searching of your power. Oh, the wonder of your glory to you 40 years. It's but 1 hour.
Check out our weekly and monthly ministries. Tuesday night Bible study, the Echoes of Praise, the United Women in Faith, the New Life Youth, and the choir. All are invited to join. Take a look at who to contact or call or email the church for more information. We are looking for our young people to be light and zeal everywhere. The youth will be participating in Youth 23 in Daytona Beach this summer. Look out for ways that you can support the youth. See the digital flyer for all the ministry updates and details. If you have a ministry announcement or want to highlight a ministry here, please contact Trisha Hamilton. Please fill out the digital I Am Here attendance and prayer request from each week that you participate in worship. Scan the QR code with your phone or click the link. We are looking forward to seeing you on Sunday mornings for worship in person or online, YouTube, or Facebook. See you next week, Saints, and keep on praying.
This is song says, I'm chasing after you, no matter what I have to do, 'cause I need you more and more. Oh, I'm chasing after you, no matter what I have to do, 'cause I need you more and more. Everybody say, I'm chasing after you, no matter what. More and more. And just said, I'm chasing after you, no matter what. want you more.